सीखो ना नैनों की भाषा पिया, कह रही तुमसे ये खामोशियां। सीखो ना लब तो ना खोलूंगी मैं समझो दिल की बोली, सीखो ना नैनों की भाषा पिया। हाँ, Now, as I was singing, I think I was singing Rangilo Maro Dholna, and suddenly out of the corner of my eye, I saw a young man make his way up the stage. Even though there were two constables, police constables standing right in front of the stage, I saw him come up, position himself right in front of my mic. So I'm behind the mic, he's ahead of the mic, and then he started doing these wriggly moves. And I'm deep into my rag, and I'm singing an alap, accompanied by tabla and harmonium, when I hear this mobile phone ring. And then, I'm not joking, but then I hear this gentleman take the mobile phone out and start talking while my alap is going on. Hello, hello, कैसे हो तुसी?
But gift concept is something that was started months back, and I'm sure it has had its own journey. What sort of
Yes.
problems did you face? What were the initial hiccups that you had, apprehensions, and where do you see it after so many months down the line? It's quite a success.
Well, yes and no. I think as an idea, it's a good idea. And I think we came up, my husband and I have had the fortune of collaborating and working with artists for several decades now. And once the pandemic hit the world as it has done, we were all, completely sort of in shock and trauma, because as artists who are used to performing all the time, I mean, our basic work is to perform to somebody, and for that to be taken away was really quite devastating for all of us. But also we felt that, this is not something that is going away in a hurry. It's going to be a while before some solutions are found. And we felt that perhaps we all need to think of using technology as a way of empowering us, even in these most devastating times. And while a lot of artists were feeling that, no, the online space isn't really conducive to music making, or it's just okay for, freebies, basically social media kind of sharing of work, which is lovely, but very often is freely given by the artist to their followers. But we wanted to see if we could perhaps come up with a sustainable revenue model. And we thought, why not try and see? Because, we are artists. Anish, my husband, and I are both musicians. But as musicians, we're also first listeners. So, as avid listeners of all kinds of music, we felt that, okay, we can't even go and listen to any concert right now. And is it possible for the concert and the artist to come into our homes at a time of our selection, on an occasion of our selection? So, for example, if I want to remember my mother by hosting a concert, is it possible for me to ask an artist that, look, I don't want a large audience. I just want for my family and friends, all of them sitting in their online, on their laptops and watching this concert. Is it possible? And then we said, well, the only way of finding out is to try, which is how Gift a Concert came into being. We thought, let's ask artists to register with us, thereby giving us permission to represent them if by chance anybody wants such an arrangement.
Movie of Mafia has been making a lot of headlines. In fact, Sonu Nigam had also said in one of his vlogs that a singer is made to sing, at least nine singers are made to sing one particular track, and then the studio decides which singers a rendition would be selected. Now, in such competitive times and under so much pressure, how would talent survive if this kind of exploitation continues? What can be done?
look, if there's a movie mafia, there you could also say there's a music mafia.
Yeah.
So, and where there's a classical music mafia also. And so, you know, I mean, maybe it's not so sinister. Let's not call it mafia, because that is almost, you know, like
conspiracy.
Yeah, I mean, let's not get into that. But parochialism, sort of not being impartial, all of these issues exist in the world of music as well. But of course, you know, through all of this, you know, when there is talent which can't be, I mean, finally, when you listen to a beautiful voice singing a gorgeous song, there is nothing that can hold that voice down. There's nothing that can stop that wonderful voice from reaching other people.
Has any of the guests ever made a weird request even after the performance is over?
I think I was singing Rangilo Maro Dholna, and suddenly out of the corner of my eye, I saw a young man make his way up the stage, even though there were two constables, police constables, standing right in front of the stage. I saw him come up, position himself right in front of my mic. So I'm behind the mic, he's ahead of the mic, and then he started doing these wriggly. And you know, I'm still singing the last part of my song, and I'm wondering, is he going to take his shirt off now? Because he was really smashed. And then before I knew what I had done, I mean, maybe that was a foolish thing on my part, so I grabbed him by the collar and pushed him aside, by which time the constables had realized that he's already on stage, and they came and took him away. But there he was, parked right in front of my microphone, wriggling away like a snake, making the most strange movements.
Has anything weird really happened during the concert that sort of, you know, left you laughing uncontrollably?
So we're singing in the outdoor, beautiful, sort of, you know, balmy winter evening, where it's not cold, but it's lovely weather. And there's flowers and trees and everything around. And I'm deep into my rag, and I'm singing an alap, accompanied by tabla and harmonium, when I hear this mobile phone ring. And then, I'm not joking, but then I hear this gentleman take the mobile phone out and start talking while my alap is going on. Hello, kaise ho tusi? Acha, to dinner pe kya bana hai? You know, and all this conversation is going on loudly. So then I stop singing, and the accompanying musicians are still playing, because they don't realize what's happening, but they can hear this. And then they stop playing. There's dead silence from us on the stage, but the conversation is going on. Oh, acha, saag bana hai. All this is happening. And then, so he finished his conversation. I waited. Then I thought I should say something sarcastic to him. So I said, aapka phone conversation ho gaya khatam. मैं आपको डिस्टर्ब नहीं करना चाहती थी, इसलिए मैंने बंद कर दिया. स्टार्ट करूं क्या फिर से? ओह हां हां, ठीक है. ही सेड नो सॉरी नथिंग.
यू नो, दिस मस्ट हैव हैपेंड टू यू ऑल द टाइम, दैट यू नो पीपल कम एंड से सम मैम वन सेल्फी. हाउ डू यू सॉर्ट ऑफ जस्ट पुश देम अवे? व्हाट डू यू डू?
Well, you know, actually, as a singer, not too many people come. It's a bit difficult when they don't understand that, for example, if you're at a restaurant, and if you happen to be at an Indian restaurant where you're using your fingers also to eat, somebody came up to me once and said, ki, Shubha ji, autograph chahiye. So I said, मैं खाना खा लूँ फिर आपको autograph देती हूँ, आप भी तो यहीं हैं. सर नहीं कोई बात नहीं. सर I didn't know what he wanted to do. Did he want me to put my fingerprints on a napkin or what?
What did you do? Did he wait, or did you have to show? You don't show
to, because there was no. I said, "Nahi, abhi to nahi ho paega. Baad mein dekhenge." But I was just didn't know what to say to him. That here I am, you know.